What's up, ladies and gentlemen? It's Mr. Big Hangos on me, back with some more Demon Souls. We're back in the Tower of Latria. Last time we died in the most upsetting way possible, really. Right at the end of the level. So I finished the...
Please, help me!
There's Rydell talking again. So I finished the episode there because I actually had to go somewhere, surprisingly. During that... Anyways, so I kind of had to end it. So I'm trying to remember where we're supposed to go. We're not even supposed to be going over here. We need to go this way. Rydell, shut up. Alright, so I think we got the key to open up... What's-his-face's cell now. Sage Frakes. So we can do that this time. And then we'll go try to fight the boss. Am I going the right way? I think I am, but I'm not sure. A drop for me. A royal lotus. Okay. I think we're going the right way. It's out here, right? I was about to say, I wonder if you can get a backstab on these guys. If you can, that's cool. Oh god, there's another one. He's dead. Drop that old spice. Okay, there should be a path this way. Isn't it? No? There's a path somewhere around here. Is this it? I can't remember exactly where the path is. This is what I mean by the Tower of Latria is confusing. Because if you die, it's hard to find out where you're actually supposed to go. Or where you were before. I think we're supposed to be going down. What is this? Prison of Hope, Warden's Key Cell. Okay, this is where we went last time, right? Where is Sage Frake? Is Sage Frake right here? Yeah, there he is. Alright, Prison of Hope, special key. What's up, Sage Frake?
Magnificent. I never expected to get out of there alive. My name is Frake. I am known as a sage. I thought my magic would give me an edge against these demons, but how wrong I was. I have been enfeebled by my long imprisonment. But I can still move my legs, and I can make it back to the Nexus. I thank the stars that I escaped when I did. I owe you my life.
Hey. No problem. Jerry's Stiletto.
I have been in...
That's all he has to say. What does Jerry's Stiletto do? Pretty sure it has like a special thing to it. An extremely small rapier, dagger size, and blade... bladeless. It is imbued with special magic. It was made by Jerry, a friend of Sage Frake the Visionary, who is known for his magical crafts. It steals a small amount of MP from his targets. That's what the special thing is. Okay. I knew it did something special, but I couldn't remember what it was. Steals MP from its target. Sounds pretty decent if you're going, like, the more magey route. Me, though, on this character, I don't think I'm worried about being too magic heavy, honestly. Not to say I won't use it, but it's not going to be that heavy in magic. So, if you wanted that, I'm sorry. I always forget about that thing. Pretty sure we have to run past it, don't we?
Please, help me!
Shut up, Rydell. Can't help you yet, dude. This game is pretty dark. So, I wanted to mention something in this episode, which is, I got... a PS2 running again, or an emulator running, I should say, and I wanted to know if you guys would be interested in seeing some old games. Because I missed out on a lot of PS2 games, good PS2 games, when I was growing up. I played a lot, but I also missed out on a lot. So I kind of wanted to go back and play some of those. And I was wondering if you guys would be interested in me recording the ones I play. Oh shit, I almost fell in that hole. I went back the other day and played through Onimusha. That game is fucking awesome. If you have ever played Onimusha or haven't played Onimusha, you definitely need to play it. It's pretty sick. Kind of hard to get used to because it has the old tank controls. But if you can get used to it, it's a badass game. Did I miss an? I missed an item over here. Stone of Ephemeral Eyes. Okay, it's not that great of an item anyway, so it's not that big a deal. All right, so we gotta take on this plague chick. That's really annoying. Let's see if we can use magic on her, possibly. I don't think she has a shield, so magic might be better against her, honestly. Oh shit, dude, that does so much damage. Okay, she does have a shield. The Armillus does so much damage though, holy fuck. Like, what the fuck is that damage? Are you kidding? Okay, I guess we're not gonna be able to use magic because her ranged attack is just too much. I hope we don't get plagued. If we get plagued, it's gonna be a problem. Okay, cool, we killed her. This chick right here is honestly harder than the boss, if you don't play it right. Black Eye Stone, Chunk of Moonlight Stone, and Stone of Ephemeral Eyes. Black Eye Stone, I think, is the invasion item in this game. I might be wrong. Allows user to invade another world. Yeah, so you can invade other people with that if you wanted to. We're playing offline, so that's probably not going to happen. I wonder if I have to go back up there and kill that guy again. I kind of don't want to. I'm going to go back up there and check, guys, just because I don't want to do the boss and then, like, her get revived 45,000 times because this guy's alive. I think he doesn't respawn, but I could be wrong, and I don't want to be, so up we go. Yeah, definitely hit me up in the comments. Would you guys be interested in seeing some old PS2 games? Like, I've already played Onimusha, so I probably won't record it. Just because, like I said, I've already played it. And I might record it later in the future, like once a few like months or maybe even a year has passed. Because I don't really want to play it again so soon. But I might play through Onimusha 2 and Onimusha 3 and like... a whole bunch. I have a whole fucking list of PS2 games that I wanted to go back and play. Like a list, like 3 pages long of like college textbook. It's ridiculous. Okay, so no, he doesn't respawn. Cool. Of like college, what's it called? Shit. Notebook, like paper. Like literally every single line is filled with a video game that I want to play on my this emulator. And Time Splitters, fucking Time Splitters, and Time Splitters 2, and Time Splitters Future Imperfect, dude. I'd love to play those games again. That was like, Future Imperfect, I think, was like one of my favorite games a long time ago. It was like amazing. One of my favorite games when I was a kid. Love to play it again, though. But yeah, definitely hit me up. I'm not saying that we're not going to do the Dark Souls series. Of course, we're going to do the whole entire series over again, but I wanted to do something alongside it, and I was wondering if you guys would be interested in that. I still need to finish Uncharted. I haven't really played too much of Uncharted lately, which I don't know how many of you guys are interested in that, but I will finish that eventually. It's just that I've been busy playing other games. I don't know. I like Uncharted, but I don't know. Like, It's a good game in, like, story. I don't know. A lot of people are going to hate me for this, but it's a good game, like, story-based, but I like gameplay, man. Gameplay's fun. And it's got good gameplay, but it's not, like... I don't know. It's more of a story-based game, I guess. Okay, so this is the Fool's Idol. And what we're gonna do, I think we're just gonna avoid all these guys. The Fool's Idol can be pretty tough, because she pulls the dumbass, what's it called? Crystal Sage thing where she turns herself. That dumbass bitch. Okay, which one is the real one? Make sure you don't step on these traps either, because if you do, you're gonna get fucked up. Okay, the big fuck, I got stepped on one. That's an issue. The one with the big lightning bolts is the real one, so it's this one. Wow, really? Me? No, that's not the right one. Where is the right one? I think it's all the way at the end. Right there. Oh my fucking god, I got stun locked. Damn it, that sucks. Wow, man. Wow. Fortunately, the one chick does not respawn, so we don't have to deal with her. This way. The freaking Fool's Idol, dude. I don't know why I'm struggling so much in Demon Souls. Usually I don't have this hard of a time with certain bosses. Like, this boss is usually pretty easy. But I've been struggling this playthrough. I don't know if it's, like, the commentary aspect where, like... A lot of people say that when you're, like, talking and playing the game, it makes it a lot harder, but, I don't think it's that, honestly. I think it's just that I've just been playing poorly. Oh. Alright. Let's get our ass down there. Maybe I can, use some type of... buff to kill her easier, possibly. What do I have? Do I have anything? I really need some more grass. I'm running out, which is ridiculous. I never run out of that stuff, usually. A firebomb. Do I have any turpentine? Yes. I guess we can use the turpentine and see if that does anything. I don't know if she's weak to anything, but I know she's definitely not weak to magic, because that's what she is. But, we can try the turpentine out and see if that works. Oh, shit. Yeah, dodge this. Yep. Alright, turpentine. Win me this fight, please. It's a good thing that you don't have to turn this damn thing off all the time. Because if you had to turn this off every single time you came here, that would fucking suck. Oh my god, that'd be so bad. Thankfully, FromSoft is smart enough to not do that. Alright, so we're gonna put on the turpentine. I don't think we're gonna put it on until we get inside. Really need some more grass. Okay, we already saw that cutscene. Okay, so right here. Turpentine it up. Let's go. It's doing more damage, but it's not doing as much as I thought it would. Oh, you're the right one? Hell yeah. Okay, cool. I don't know if there's any other way to tell, honestly, if she's the right one or not. Where's the right one at? I didn't see it. It's that one. Oh, wow, right in front of you? Wow, dude, that's so... I hate those things, man. Which one is it? The one behind me. I don't know which one it is, still. I'm dead. No, I'm not. Oh, now I am. Motherfucker! God damn it. It was the one all the way at the end. I don't know if there's another way to tell other than her soul spear. I can't remember. It's been so long since I played. This is the most I've died on this boss in years. This is ridiculous. Man, dude, I'm struggling. Playing all these PS... Well, actually, no. PSP games are actually pretty difficult. No joke. Like... I don't know if you guys are, like, used to this, but if you go back in time and play some of these old PS2 games and these old, like, PlayStation 1, PS2, maybe even some of the older Nintendo games, like, they are fucking hard. No joke, they're hard. I think Dark Souls and Demon Souls did a good job of, like, trying to captivate that essence, because if you play a game nowadays and then you go back to that PS2 era, you guys will see how difficult the older games are. It's ridiculous. Even the fucking little kids games are, like, difficult. There's too many games nowadays that have, like, that Halo / Call of Duty health where it, like, regens. If you go back and play some of these kids games, it's like a 3-hit, you're dead type of thing. And, I'm gonna be honest, it's not easy. It's not fucking easy to avoid getting hit 3 times. You know, I think I was playing fucking SpongeBob Battle for Bikini Bottom or something, and I died to, like, these damn robots or something the other day. It's ridiculous. And yes, I did play SpongeBob. That game is honestly good, no joke. I don't really like many kids' games, but, SpongeBob, A Battle for Bikini Bottom is, no joke, really good. I don't know, maybe I just like collect-a-thons, because it's like one of those games where you have to collect a lot of stuff. And I like that. I like that type of game, honestly. I don't know why I like that type of game, but I just do. Maybe we should use a... Maybe I'm gonna hide behind here and see if I can pull out a faster weapon, possibly. Do I have anything that has better magic defense? I don't think so. Let's see, can we get a faster weapon up in here? I don't know if you can poison her. I'm pretty sure you can't. I don't have anything better, really. I forgot that I took everything off because of this. Because of how this game works. Does she spawn in the same spot every time? I wonder. Which one would it be? That one, yeah. So she kind of does spawn in the same spot. No, that's not her. What the fuck? I thought for sure that was it. Which one's the right one? It's that one. Okay. No. There she is. No. No! Are you fucking kidding me, dude? I hate those fucking things. God, I hate those things that, like, stop you in your place. What the fuck? Why? I'm losing so much grass, man. I don't even have enough grass to fucking do this fight anymore. Are you kidding me? I did not expect this boss to be such a pain in the ass. Honestly, this boss is honestly one of the easiest bosses in the game. How am I having such a difficult time against her? It's because of this shitty ass weapon, man. Bastard sword's fucking garbage. Why am I even using this weapon? I should go back to using the scimitar because it's faster. This weapon takes up too much stamina. For like one swing. Well, it's a good thing I didn't go into body form in this level because... Damn, my freaking world Tennessee would have got shattered. This is really hard, man. Really freaking hard. I don't know why I'm struggling so hard. It's just because of the health, man. There's not really any places to hide and heal. I don't have much health. And this sword sucks. I'm trying to think, man. What can I do? If there was a place to, like, actually hide... Probably be a lot easier. I'm pretty sure you can't poison her. Now I'm thinking to myself, why the fuck did I level up the bastard sword so much? Because it's not even that good. I thought this shit was going to carry me, but clearly I was wrong. What is this item over here? Storied soldier soul. Nothing good. That's the one that gives plague, I'm pretty sure. Is it that one? Yeah, okay. And then she spawns all the way back here, I'm pretty sure. He's the one that always fires last as well. Hmm. problem is, where are the places where I can stand and where are the places where I can't? I didn't mean to stand right there, but okay. Heal, you fool. Okay. And then is this one, right? It's not that one. Now we're like out of grass completely, which is not good. What is this thing right here? Oh, that's where I died, I guess. Did I not have any souls in my corpse when I died? Okay, I guess. Royal Lotus. Is there anything else around here? I don't think so. We already got the plague thing or whatever. I think it's called the baby's nail or something like that. And this is where the real Demon Souls begins. Anyways, we're gonna go up here to the thing that's gonna take us back home. Because we do not wanna do this section yet, because we'll get fucked up. So let's go back. Turn to the Nexus. With 8,000 souls and one half moon grass left. Fantastic. Yes, one half moon grass. That's fucking terrible. Thinking about switching my weapon, because the bastard sword is not cutting it. It's good against normal enemies, but against bosses you have to be fast, especially for some of the upcoming bosses like the flame worker and the man eaters. You really have to be fast. So I think we're gonna get rid of this. Let's see if Ostrava has anything new to say.
But in the dark state of
nope. All right, let's level up a few times here.
Thou seekest soul power, dost thou not? Then
thou seekest soul of the mind,
key to life's ether.
Soul I definitely want to get to 20.
Drawn from its vessel.
Here, let's use the soul. I want to get to 20 vitality, at least. That's like my one full moon grass. We have full moon grass, but I really don't want to use it. One more should let us get to level 20 in that. Alright.
Soul of the mind, key to life's ether.
20 vitality. It's good. Let's go drop off some of these weapons and get one of my other weapons out. Honestly, deposit. Let's deposit all this stuff. Let's get... Wait, where? There we go. Drop all this stuff off. Can I even carry that stuff yet? I bet if I get rid of this sword, I might be able to carry this armor. Deposit. Well, actually, I want to take. Alright, what sword do we want? We could take the scimitar if we wanted to. Crushing battle axe is good in the place that we're about to go. So I might take that. How much does the battle axe weigh? 2.5. That's not that bad. Let's take that. It's gonna be good in the place that we're about to go, I'm pretty sure. Because I think these enemies are weak too.
You have a.
I think they're weak to blunt weapons. And the crushing battle axe in this game counts as a blunt weapon. What is my weight right now? Equip burden 20 out of 37. So what, are we just over the fucking thing? Take off the wizard's gloves and the assassin's helmet. No, still not enough. How do I change? There we go. 18.7, okay, that's still too much. What if we take off this? Okay, now we're good. Now what if we put this back on, is it too much? Yep, damn. Damn. Alright then, let's see if we can upgrade the crushing battle axe. Oh, no, you can't upgrade it. That's fucking right. I can't remember what type of stone do you need to upgrade the battle axe? You know what? We're not going to use the battle axe. Deposit. I'm so confused right now on what to use, because we need a blunt weapon. But literally every blunt weapon we have weighs too much. Hold on, is the fluted armor... It's like 3 pounds more. 2 pounds. Let's do that. Deposit. Plus that as well. Take out the Great Club.
You have a.
I think the Great Club might be better here. Oh, do I not even have the strength to carry the Great Club yet? Oh, 20 strength. Wow. Never mind. I guess we're stuck with the battle axe. I hope it's enough. Pause it.
You have a heart of.
Alright. Let's go over here real quick and talk to these people.
But among them could.
You don't have anything new to say? No, neither do these guys. I think we need to go over here. Yeah, Sage Frake should be over here now.
You saved Sage Frake, did you not? Then I was right to bend the rules and teach you a few tricks. Nevertheless, I'm grateful to you. Do you see how important selfless acts are in this dreary world?
Yeah. All right, what's up, Sage Frake?
I have a proposal for you. Could you bring your demon souls to me? As I determine more about the essence of the soul, I can teach you new magic. A demon soul is no mere amalgamation of lesser souls. You have your wits about you. Surely you understand me?
Yeah. Learn spell. Enchant weapon. I kind of want to get enchant weapon.
I
I am going to get Enchant Weapon. So let's... We got to use a whole bunch of these souls up. This is going to be a longer video, which makes no sense because all we did was fight the fucking Fool's Idol. But, yeah. I just need to use three of these. Learn weapon. Let me learn. There we go. Remember.
Bring back.
Okay. Let's get my freaking thing out again. Take. Silver catalyst.
You have a.
Alright, let's see. Does this work on the Crushing Battle Axe? Yes, it does. Okay, that's good. That's useful. Alright, cool. So, what else can I do here before we move on anywhere? I need to drop off the old demon or the old doll soul or whatever, because I really don't want that with me, because I don't want to accidentally use it. Don't need the black bolts. Anything else? Attack power rises at 30% or lower HP.
You have a.
You have a heart of gold. Don't let them take it from you. I don't think there's anything else we can do, really. I guess we could level up one more time if we use some souls. The minimum we need?
Soul of the mind, key to life.
I shall awake. Okay. I just want to carry around 1,000 souls because I'm about to go kill myself so we can, kill myself so we can get out of body form. That should be enough.
Then, soul of the mind, key to life's ether.
Endurance.
Soul of the Lord.
Is this what
it, yeah, from its vessel.
We wanna definitely get, you know, I'm gonna level up as much as I can. We're gonna get endurance up. Because I really need it. Really wish you could use multiple souls at one time, but whatever. Here, I know how to do this in an easier way, I suppose. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Damn it. There we go. We're just gonna use all these souls up. Next episode, we'll probably go on to World 4, Level 1. Let's see what we can do there. Our guy. Just eating all these souls up. Why does my character look so pissed off? Like, look at him. He's like, fuck this world, man. Well, I guess I would be pissed off, too, if I had to fight a fucking doll demon 400 times. Is it time to do the duplicate glitch, guys? So we can get 1 million souls to spend on ourselves. We could do it. If we want to. Alright. Level up.
Soul of the mind, key to life's ether.
Okay, it's at 13 now. So we should actually be able to wear the fluted armor now. Going back and forth, man. Going back and forth. Okay. I know. I just can't figure out what I want to do. Take item. Fluted armor. Actually, would it be better to just take the helmet? It might be better to just take the helmet instead. No, I can't wear the helmet. Motherfucker.
Oops.
Posit the helmet. Take the armor.
Yeah.
Is there anything else that we can... What's our...
Well, you have
I
a...
need to look at my equipment burden again so I can make sure. 18.7 out of 42. What is the fucking... Is it like 25%? Or something? Alright, we're just going to go with this. I'm going to kill myself real quick and then I'll end the episode because next time we'll do 4-1. Which... 4-1, the boss is extremely easy in 4-1. I say that now, but I'll probably die. The boss is easy in 4-1, but the level is difficult, if that makes sense. The regular enemies in the level, like the normal enemies, can be difficult, but the boss is pretty easy, so we'll see how it goes. But let me pick up these souls first. And then I'll buy, you know what, I'm gonna buy some crescent moon grass. Alright, so it's already equipped. Let's put some full moon grass on there too, just in case. Alright, that's gonna be it for this episode, guys. Hopefully you guys did enjoy it. I know there was a lot of back and forth bullshit at the end of this episode, and we had to fight the fool's idol like 5 times, but hopefully you guys enjoyed it through all that madness. If you did, don't forget that like button and subscribe. Until next time, guys, I'll see y'all later. Peace out.